Definitely, you are treating me as an academician. I appreciate it, but I wonder whether I can live up to the expectation. One thing that comes to my mind is that the center here in this prestigious university should look into the region as a whole, not as an individual country. What I mean is that instead of just looking at Korea or looking into Japan or trying to understand the process in China, you might think about these countries as a region. For instance, things are all related. Free trade agreements between China and Korea. What's going on between Japan and Korea? What's the limitation of the foreign policies between Japan and Korea? Or integration process, small steps they may be, but we have been making some steps towards integration. We have set up a secretariat for trilateral meetings and talks. These are ones that come to my mind. On bilateral issues, we have to understand the society of each country. I don't want to go into the territory of these esteemed professors and Japanese studies, but as there was a case of this comfort woman or Yasukuni Shrine issue, time and again I repeat this point on part of the Korean government. We are willing to become a part of this Japan because we share the most important thing for contemporary people, that is democracy and market economy. But we are curtailed by a mindset of many Japanese leaders. The Prime Minister makes an apology. The next day, some of these poor members of the party denies it or visits Shrine and makes an unacceptable statement. That has made us very difficult to become a companion for making this region more advanced liberal democracy and market economy. But again, this the more aggressive China has led us to conclude this comfortable issue. Is it truly behind us? I don't know. There are still remaining nationalistic sentiments in both countries. Something will surely come out. We have to manage it and work together for a better future based on market economy and economic growth. These are, well, this is another issue you can think about. I believe that this is at least a master's degree thesis.
Each and every Indian states are equally becoming
have different certain areas that equally in the course of time. So what is the experience and how do you deal with that? Well, you know, surely better than I do, because I've been here just 4 months, and I must say that I have been a happy explorer of different facets of your great country, and I have been to a number of states. Always happy to visit different culture and different, like hearing different languages and so on. You are right. These differences sometimes confuse us, confuse me at least. But this is a happy discovery. A happy discovery of India. And Korean businessmen usually land in one of the states. And they make themselves very accustomed to the local and the state level, state dimensional environment. That's what they do. As for the embassy, we try to have a bird's eye view, and if needed, if requested, we try to provide them with some advices. So it works well. I do not complain about having 29 states in your country. Please don't be offended when I use this analogy. I was almost pulled by my arm to come to a certain state for the business side. It was not long after my visit to the capital of the state, and I was not I was inclined not to visit a second time, but I was forced. Then I said that, well, I recognize the importance of our bilateral relationship, and in our relationship with your state. But I have 28 other states to please. It's not a monogamy. But it's fun. I like it very much.
Young people.